The government on an overdrive to reassure the economy. High-level meetings between the Prime Minister and Finance Minister, followed by discussions with RBI Governor D. Subba Rao late in the night on Monday, followed by a Tuesday morning press briefing by the Finance Minister himself. Asserting that both Reserve Bank and the government are on the same page on measures taken to stabilize the rupee, P. Chidambaram said recent RBI measures are intended to quell speculation of the forex market and to reduce volatility.
We must increase credit delivery and we must stimulate growth. For example, I don't expect banks to increase the interest rate as a result of yesterday's measures. Measures taken to quell excessive speculation and reduce volatility and stabilize the rupee.
He added that there will be some depreciation of rupee in view of high current account deficit and inflation.
Given an emerging economy's inflation and given the current account deficit, some depreciation of the rupee is to be expected. But the rupee will appreciate or depreciate, as I said, depending upon how much foreign exchange we earn and how much foreign exchange we spend.
Monday night saw the RBI announcing a slew of measures in an attempt to stem the continuing fall of the rupee. RBI has raised lending rates to commercial banks by 2% to 10.25% from current 8.25%. The measure will make it unattractive for banks to borrow rupee at cheap rates and buy dollars in the forward markets. This will also reduce the pressure on the rupee. Putting further curbs under liquidity adjustment facility, RBI announced that the overall allocation of funds under the LAF will be limited to 1% of the net demand and time liabilities of the banking system. This is aimed to suck liquidity from the system and prevent banks from taking speculative position in forward markets. The RBI will also conduct open market sales of bonds of 12,000 crore rupees on Thursday to further suck out liquidity from the system. The rupee has weakened by more than 12% against the dollar since May, making it one of the worst performing currencies among the emerging markets. The free fall of the currency can be attributed to continued dollar demand, month-end requirement by corporates and oil companies, rise in the USD vis-a-vis other currencies, bearish sentiments towards emerging economies, and withdrawal of FIIs from both debt and equity markets. A weaker rupee is a matter of concern for India as India imports for over 70% of its oil and gas requirements and the depreciation of the local currency has made imports more expensive, thereby putting pressure on the economy by high prices. Business Desk, DD News.